I love when you said that he knew their failures when he called them. And that has been such a, like, I hold on to that so dear sometimes, because I remember there were times when I first started following the Lord that I thought, he's never going to use me. Like, I don't know how he could use someone like me. And I really believed that lie for so long, that my failures, my shortcomings, my scripts were too big for God. And I'm just here to say that you are not too much of a screw up. You're not too much of a failure for God to use you. One of my favorite stories that I see Jesus interacting with the woman is when he met the woman at the well. If you've grown up in church, you know the story. It's in John chapter 4. Jesus has a divine moment with a Samaritan woman. And the thing I love about this story is that we have to remember is that Jesus is walking around, and yes, Jesus is thirsty. So he ends up at this well and he's asking this woman if she could get some water for him. But Jesus is fully God. Like, Jesus made this woman. Jesus knows her story. Jesus knows everything about her. And he has this interaction with her. And without, you know, divulging too much, we know that this woman was probably here because she felt like an outcast potentially, or she felt like she didn't want to be around the other woman. And I have felt that before. I have felt like I have messed up too much. I don't know how God could use someone like me. I've screwed up too much. God could not use someone like me. My story, my past is too messed up. And what we see here is we see Jesus meet with this woman and talk with her and offer her water that she could never go thirsty again, the living water. But here is the best part of this whole story, you guys. It gets me so excited. At the very end, after this woman has this interaction with Jesus, she goes back to the town and tells everyone there, guys, guess who I just met? I just met the man, the Messiah, who told me everything I ever did. And then it says this in verse 39, many Samaritans believed in him because of her testimony. A woman who just moments earlier was potentially feeling like an outcast, potentially feeling like she was not good enough, potentially feeling like she wasn't worthy to be having this interaction. She goes back to her town and many people believed because of her testimony. God used this woman to become an evangelist right there in her own town to tell people about the Messiah. And I always cling to this story and think, first of all, Jesus loved her. Jesus met her right where she was. Jesus never looked at her and said, oh, I don't know if I could use someone like you because of your story. The truth is that God has a specific plan for each of us, and he has ways that he's going to use us. And seeing Jesus meet this woman right where she was, it helped me understand, okay, God could use someone like me. God could use someone with a story like mine. God knows me. He actually, here's the crazy thing, you guys. When Jesus died for me, he knew everything I was ever going to do. Like, God knows us. We cannot surprise him. We cannot screw up enough where he goes, wow, didn't see that one coming. No, he's like, I know you. I created you and I love you in spite of yourself. And I want to use you. And so I have learned that lesson. I am certain that you guys have as well. And it is a comfort to me. It is a comfort to me to know that God is in the business of using broken people, because here's the deal. It's all he has to work with. Like, there's nobody out there that has all of their stuff together where they've never messed up and they're never making mistakes. God is using the best people he has, and that's you and I right where we are.
Hi, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe today and you'll never miss a new upload. Thanks for being a part of our Better Together community.